In Georgia, the governor says the state will allow some businesses to reopen beginning tomorrow. That's a week before his previous stay-at-home order expires. It's a decision President Trump said yesterday he disagrees with. So far, Georgia has seen more than 20,000 cases and more than 800 deaths from COVID-19. We have two views on how local communities in the state are preparing to reopen. First, from Scott James Matheson. He's the mayor of Valdosta in southern Georgia. Mayor Matheson, thank you very much for talking with us. First of all, did the governor consult with you? Were you surprised when you learned there was going to be this partial reopening this week?
So constant contact along the way, but no, I was caught by surprise that he went a week early. We were under the statewide order for shelter at home through the 30th, so I thought the natural day to walk back in was going to be Friday, May 1st. It did catch me by surprise.
And excuse me, and what did you think when you heard the governor say we're going to start to reopen gyms, hair salons, barbershops, and then places of where people go to eat, restaurants, starting next week, some of them?
Yep, I think we're going to go to restaurants and theaters starting on Monday, but this Friday, tomorrow, we're on the eve of starting the state, or kickstarting our town again, and we'll adapt. If he says that's the way to go, then he's been pretty spot on most of the way, so we'll adapt.
I'm sure you know, Mayor Matheson, that health experts are quite mixed and divided on this question. Many of them say until we know more about who's been exposed to COVID-19, that it's risky to do this. How are you thinking about making your own decision on this?
Well, when he releases us, once we get out from under that state order on the 30th, it will be my decision again. But right now, again, as you can see around me, we're at a shelter at home still. So we're spending most of our time here. When we come out from under it, we're going to move as a community together. Lowndes County as a whole has done very well. We've only had 122 cases, only four fatalities. So in a population of about 120,000 city and county, that's I think I've calculated it as 0.08%. So we'll move on the fact that we've been doing pretty good from the very beginning.
Did it give you pause when you heard President Trump say he disagreed with Governor Kemp's decision?
Yeah, sure. What do you do with the top dog, and then the top dog in your state are in disagreement? It puts it back in your lap. And again, I think we, the county commission chairman and myself, have moved very responsibly the entire way, and we'll continue to do so. I think our town and our people have moved very responsibly, so we're going to go on that. And obviously, you know, just to our west by an hour and a half, we have the hot spot in the country in Daugherty County, Georgia. So we obviously have to keep an eye on the communities around us as well.
What kind of steps are you taking in Valdosta as your, again, beauty salons, barbershops, bowling alleys open, and then restaurants and movies next week? What kinds of things are going to be different?
Well, we're going to continue to meet with all our health experts. Our Department of Public Health has done a very good job in the state. Our major medical center in South Georgia Medical Center here, we meet with them twice daily, believe it or not, and that keeps us up to speed on any developments. In the town, we're just going to let the business owners realize that people are not going to rush back. Shelter at home order is still into the 30th, so they're going back a week ahead of that. And I got to factor, they're just going to get a chance to fight for their business and fight for their life. Their business is not going to come back in anytime soon, so I wish them the best of luck.
Are the medical experts you're talking to, the people you trust, in the healthcare community, are they in agreement that this is the right thing?
I don't think so. I think they still approach it with lots of words of caution, as a matter of fact. We're going to move forward with a balance. We lean toward their advice first and foremost, but then we got to know the business community has to have a voice at the table as well.
Mayor Scott Matheson of Valdosta, Georgia, thank you very much for talking with us, and we wish you the very best.
Thank you, Judy.
And now a different perspective on Georgia's planned reopening. Mayor Hardie Davis of Augusta joins us. Mayor Davis, thank you very much for talking with us. And what was your reaction when you learned from Governor Kemp that things will start to reopen in the state tomorrow?
Ms. Woodruff, I was surprised, quite frankly, as many of my colleagues were across the state of Georgia. Again, as the mayor of Georgia's second largest city, someone who's enjoyed a strong relationship with Governor Kemp, I think when we looked at the fact that just a week prior, he extended the shelter in place order until the 30th of April, and of course, the pandemic declaration of emergency until the 13th of May, it was just quite frankly shocking that we would move to that place as quickly as we were, in light of the fact that we still in Georgia cannot conduct sufficient enough testing across the state, let alone in Augusta. We're not able to do contact tracing in sufficient numbers. And then, of course, the issues around treatment, but given the fact that there's no current vaccine and or therapies for this, I think it's very difficult to think that we're going to move to a place under the assumption that we've already reached the peak in Georgia, let alone in any of these communities that we find ourselves in.
Well, given that, are you going to comply with what the governor says is going to happen? I noticed he said that there's not, he said local action can't be taken that's more or less restrictive than what he's saying.
Well, again, I think all of us across the state are going to comply with the governor's executive order. What I've shared with folks in Augusta is that we're going to take a very deliberative approach in terms of how we comply with that, particularly in terms of giving guidance to those business owners, whether it's our restaurants, whether it's our barbershops, hair salons, nail salons, and of course our gymnasiums that are going to be opening up. We're working very hard to make sure that we're communicating, one, what the governor's executive order clearly states and expects of people. We've also told folks that they should be waiting on guidance from the governor's office so that they can be very clear about what the requirements and expectations are. The reality of it, as we move forward, is that this will become the norm. I don't even want to use the term a new norm, but it's going to be the norm in terms of social distancing, the requirements around sanitization in places of business, whether it's restaurants or gymnasiums. We're going to do things differently in terms of how we conduct business.
Right.
And as it relates to the people, you know, yes, there's always the question of personal responsibility, but none of us expected, planned for, or anticipated COVID-19 being the issue of the day.
Just quickly, what percentage of the businesses affected do you think are actually going to go ahead and reopen tomorrow?
Well, we're getting emails. We've gotten them since Monday, and you've got mixed responses from people. You've got some who say, Mayor, we're going to continue to follow your lead and not open yet. We don't believe that we've met the peak. And then you've got some who are saying they're going to do soft openings that are really focused around keeping their buildings clean, going in and doing a deep clean and sanitization. But beyond that, it's a fairly mixed response, particularly because people are afraid. They're concerned about the fact that, one, you could be working with someone who's asymptomatic and carrying the virus, and the next thing you know, not only are you infected, but your colleagues who you work with are infected as well. So they're proceeding with a grave abundance of caution.
And finally, quickly, I know you have a major medical center there in Augusta. What sort of advice are you getting from the medical community?
Well, they too share the concern around the fact that we haven't reached our peak yet. They've also been identified by the governor as the lead agency for testing for the state of Georgia. And so they're proceeding with caution as well. And that's the guidance that they're giving us here in Augusta, along with my other hospitals. We've got a fairly strong healthcare community here. So I think we have those resources available to us, but it's just the unknowns around testing, who has the virus and who doesn't.
Mayor Hardie Davis of Augusta, Georgia, thank you very much. And we wish you the very best with all you're doing.
Thanks so much, Judy.